Hello everybody, thank you all for watching a new episode of DIYC to my $5 trailer plane. And today it's, and the wind died down, but also the temperature went really low. It's freezing cold, but the sun is up and it's a beautiful sunny day. So we are going to attempt to fly right here above the water. It's been a while that we have flown this plane because it was always windy, rain and storms. And we had some improvements made because in the last episode we did testing the servos using the new toolkit servo tester that also showed the amps that was drawing, and we showed that the 4 amps that this 9 gram HTX servos draws 0.6 amps per servo. Mile 4 is 2.4 and had a back BAC that only was rated for 2 amps, so that was too low. So we improved the BAC, the links down below, and the video to the servo toolkit I see up here, because we had some really interesting figures and things that we found out in the toolkit RC video about servos. So definitely recommend to see that video. You have to go back. We upgraded the BAC that delivers 3 amps, plus we can switch from 5 volts to 6 volts. That improves the power and the speed from the servos. You get more torque and it reacts faster, but also increase of course the amps. And I just improved to 3 amps just to get for the 5 volts amp rating that we did on the servo RC tester. And we tested the motor with this propeller, 9x50 20-12 AD motor, 1400 kV on a 3S. That was the drawing 16 amps, and I was using a 30 amp EC. Well, I'm still using it, but the next upgrade is going to downgrade it to a 20 amp EC, because this is all I need. Unless I have a flight, that was all from all the new upgrades and things that we had. And that video from the toolkit RC watt meter will be linked over here, because it went up to 150 amps. That's a crazy amount. You can even test it for your drones and all 4 motors at the same time. It's super easy, just plug it into your drone and test the amps. Another wonderful tool that you need in your toolkit if you're in love with RCs. So let's go and see how good this flies. It makes my day.
Let's test all the servos. Everything's working. Let's put the ailerons together with the rudder. Well, there's not a lot of movement in the rudder, but it is moving. Okay, now we have some movement and it's nice straight. Just having a look at the ailerons. Those are nice and level together, almost the same. So let's toss it into the wind, the small smile breeze that it is, and look straight up in the sun. It's horrible. Feels like the battery is like half empty, but it's probably because of the cold. I just don't have that crazy amount of thrust that I used to have. Ooh baby, he's flying, he's flying. Let's do a touch and go. I feel like a touch and go. And a touch and go, nice one. Take off. Get some altitude, take the corner, yep, she's flying really nice, not crazy, very gentle, very smooth. She's still in good working condition, after sitting still for at least half a year. Yeah. Ooh, that was a close one. That's a horrible sun again, but no wind. With weather like this, I have to make full use of it, because man, it doesn't happen often, because this is the wind valley and the name says it all. There's always wind. But in the winter we have days like this and I need to make full use of it. Even if it's cold, I'm still out here making videos for you guys. I hope you're appreciating these videos, and please give it a thumbs up. Please give it a thumbs up for my unbreakable $5 trainer plane that is flying awesome. I couldn't wish for anything better. That's my this sitting still for 6 months. But still, looking really good. After we had some really bad crashes last time that we did fly this, we had some really close calls, but it survived every crash, as you can see. There's nothing has changed except for the few upgrades that we made with the BEC. I really hope you like this episode. Thanks for watching. And I hope to see you next time. This is DIYC signing out. Goodbye.